classmates. My presentation topic is historical truth versus literary truth. Generally, we are used to saying that what has happened really in past is called the history. But being the literary student, we all know that what is the difference between the literature, what is history and what is literature. So let me go direct by point. Literature is based on the imaginations. It is look like a beautiful photograph, whereas the history is based on reality or fact and looks like a X-ray images. So first of all, we define the historical truth. History deals with the particular facts. Facts means that we can say that many years ago there was a king and who ruled over the Bangladesh, Maharaja Krishnakumar Singh Ji. That is a fact. It is the history. And always the issue use the name of the real character, because what is possible is credible. It is a very important to use the real name in the history. What actually happened in past is described in a particular way. From the history we can get the information what really happened in the past. No justice found. In the history there is no possibility that always we can found the justice as of we find in literature, that because the history there is no always good being over the bad. Now the literary truth deals with the universal truth. Writer, poet doesn't describe what happened but describe what may be or could be happened. They can change the name of the character. We have a recent example of the Hamlet. Vishal Bhardwaj made the movie Heather. It changed the Hamlet character into the Heather. They have a right and poetic freedom to change the facts. And we found the poetic justice also. And Vishal Bhardwaj makes many changes in his movie Heather from the source of written history. We find the poetic justice. At the end of the literary text, we find the poetic justice means the good always overwin the bad. Now we have an example of Paradise Lost. Historical truth, there is a source of the biblical story. Biblical story of Eve and Adam, this is the theological story. Where literary truth, Paradise Lost by Joel Minton. There is many changes in Paradise Lost. We find that there are only two chapters in Bible related to history of Eve and Adam, whereas Milton creates a very huge book from that history of theology. Milton changed the character Eve from the statistic Bible to dynamic in Paradise Lost. Eve's character is larger in Paradise Lost than the story of Genesis. Milton creates Eve as a complex woman in Paradise Lost. So the biblical material and the fictional adding by John Milton is very different. According to Paul, Saint Paul, man is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of man. And we find in Paradise Lost there is many fictional adding like arguments between the Eve and Shaitan, dialogues like the fellowship, conversations, social communication. Those all are that describe the difference between the historical truth and the literary truth. There are other examples of the literary truth versus historical truth. The portions of Mahabharata, the story of Eklavya, and we have syllabus story, the purpose by D.P. Kailasam. The Eklavya, in D.P. Kailasam, we find the Eklavya is a tragic hero, and the Mahabharata, we find the Arjuna as a hero. Here we can say that the poet has a right to change the fact. This is a very important in the literary truth. Character of Karna in Mahabharata and the play Karnabhar by Sanskrit poet Bhasha. There are also differences between the both characters. As Karna in Mahabharata, Karna is a historical character and Bhasha describes him as a great grand hero in this play. The character of Duryodhana from the Mahabharata. In Mahabharata, we find Duryodhana as a very cruel person and a bad person. But Bhasha in his Bhasha writes the play on Duryodhana, making him Suryodhana at the end of his play Urugam. Urugam is the best example to make the minor character to major character in Urugam. Urugam described the Duryodhana as the best and kind human person in his whole play. Here we have many other examples of Ramayana, like Valmiki's Ramayana and Tulsidas's Ramayana. We have all find the many versions of Ramayana, like Ramananda Sagar Ramayana, and today is now this day is the Morari Babu's Ramayana, also famous in our society. So I describe the what is the difference between Valmiki Ramayana and Tulsidas's Ramcharitmanas. In Valmiki Ramayana, Rama killed Vali from hitting, while Vali and Sugriva were engaged in duel. So the questions arise, why Rama did not challenge Vali face to face, whereas Tulsidas does not deal with the issue. This is the most major difference between the Valmiki Ramayana and Tulsidas's Ramayana. In Ramcharitmanas, story of Sati testing Rama when he is searching for Sita, where Valmiki Ramayana has 36 sons of Balaram and story of Parvati. This is also differences between the Valmiki Ramayana and Tulsidas Ramayana. There are both different, and this is the most important difference, that the Ramcharitmanas is composed by Tulsidas as Shiva appeared dream and told him to write, whereas Valmiki wrote Ramayana as a Smriti. This is the major difference between these two. Valmiki Ramayana as we can history, and Ramcharitmanas as we can add additional one. And so we can say that from this illustration we can conclude that literary truth is beautiful and aesthetically delight than the historical one. We remember history because there is a literature on history, and we do not try to read more much history, but all these characters are remained for still now this day because of on them literature. They are immortal because there is a literature on them, and the universal time, universal and timeless. They describe the permanence of the literature, and we can say that at last literary truth is better than the historical one.